So the power takeoff, or the PTO component of a tractor, is an extremely powerful part of the tractor that is transferring power from the tractor to implements like this potato digger, or rototillers, wood chippers, corn choppers. So a lot of our powered equipment is run off of the PTO shaft. Due to the high amount of power that's being transferred from the tractor to the implements through these PTO shafts, it's extremely important to be very careful and to have a safety mindset around these shafts. So in this video, we're going to really focus on PTO safety and avoiding accidents related to PTO shafts. So at working speed, our PTO shafts are spinning at 540 rotations per minute, or 9 times per second. And there's no amount of human force that's going to stop that spin from happening. So we want to do everything possible to just avoid those areas. So there's a number of factors that lead to PTO shaft related accidents. One is stepping over the PTO shaft itself while it's attached to the tractor and while the tractor is running. So we really want to get into the practice of walking all the way around the implements as opposed to stepping over the PTO shaft. Another cause of PTO related accidents is connected to your clothing. So wearing loose and baggy clothing, clothing with strings like sweatshirts, having your shoelaces untied, jewelry and long hair are all things that could get caught in a spinning PTO shaft. So whenever you're working around tractors, you wanna make sure your shoelaces are tied, make sure you have relatively tight fitting clothes, have your hair tied back, and avoid jewelry. We also wanna avoid having chains or ropes and other types of tools on the platform of the tractor down around your feet. What can happen is that those chains can fall off the back as you're operating and get entangled around the PTO, causing severe damage to the tractor and also potential severe damage to the operator. So really want to make sure that this area is clear. That includes just hanging chains and ropes from like your three-point hitch system on the back and even from the bucket on the front. You want to make sure that those are very secure or not on the tractor at all. So this is a PTO stub. This is the component that is attached to the tractor that is creating that power and force. And it's the component that the PTO shaft off of the implement is attaching onto. So if this is spinning, even without an implement attached to it, can be a source and a cause for entanglement. So we really want to make sure that the PTO is disengaged so that this isn't spinning whenever we're back here working around the tractor. And ideally, the tractor would be totally off whenever you're working around this back side of the tractor. And one of the major causes of accidents around PTO shafts is missing and broken shields. So we can see on this sprayer that we have a plastic shield and that can spin freely over the shaft that's inside it. So with this one, we've got a guard over this universal joint. So this is pretty well protected once it gets hooked up to the tractor. This is well protected where it connects to the implement. And when we're operating these, we'll chain the shield to a stationary location so that the shaft spins freely inside the shield. So if we were to accidentally bump up against this, there's very little chance of getting entangled and sucked into the shaft. And another potential source of PTO shaft accidents is inappropriate attachment of the shaft to the tractor. So I'm gonna take a second and just walk you through how to attach the shaft to the tractor and how to make sure that it is in place and secure. So the first step is to take your master shield here that's attached to the tractor and just get that out of your way so you have a little bit more working room and you can see what you're working on. but very important to make sure to put that back down after you're done attaching the PTO. So next we're gonna work to align the grooves in the stub off of the tractor with the grooves of the PTO shaft on the implement. So sometimes this can be kind of difficult. It can make it easier to lift the implement up if you have like a rototiller or a flail mower so that you can spin everything easily. It just makes it a little easier to work with. And then after everything's lined up, you want to find the button that moves the bearing out of the way so that you can get your shaft onto the stub. So on this one we have a button. Other PTO shafts will have a collar system where you pull that back, which allows you to slide everything together. So here we're gonna lift this up, extend the telescopic shaft that we have here, push the button in, get everything lined up, and start to move that in. If I only move that an inch or two in, it feels like it's in place, but it's actually not secured. So what I need to do is push this all the way in and pay attention to the collar or the pin that you are pushing. Push it in until you hear that click. Once that clicks, that means that the bearing has fallen back in place. It's engaged with the groove on the PTO shaft on the tractor, and you should not be able to pull that off. So that's another way to check and make sure you're in place. You can pull on this, make sure it doesn't move. And lastly, you can look in behind your universal joint in here and make sure that the stub from the tractor is lined up and flush with the hole on the universal joint. Okay, so to avoid PTO related accidents and entanglements, we want to make sure that we're only ever working around the backside of the tractor when the tractor is completely off. We want to create a culture of always walking around the tractor as opposed to stepping over the drawbar and the PTO shield. We want to make sure that we have tight fitting clothing and that we're avoiding any kind of loose articles of clothing that could get entangled. And lastly, we want to ensure that the PTO shaft is securely attached to the tractor. If you have an implement on your farm that has a missing PTO shield or a broken shield, you can contact the Bassett Healthcare Network and check out their personal protective equipment catalog to get reduced costs on replacement PTO shields and other personal protective equipment.